the jury what all these markings are and why you place them where you place them.
Yeah, so this is a representation of the crime scene, the entrance to the Petro where we come in this direction when I first arrived.
Not to cut you off, but you're pointing to the bottom of the map. Is that correct?
Yes.
You guys would enter through...
Yes, there's an entrance gate here that's made by a security guard. When I originally came in, I came through the security gate in this direction. I observed EMS and other officers tending to Mr. Stevens up here, and I pulled around to the government truck, which is here.
Okay, let's go back to the blue circle. So the blue circle on the map is Stevens' first aid site. Is that also represented by S12, which is the photograph on the projector at the moment? Okay. So then you said you proceeded to the Covenant truck, which you marked with a yellow box?
Yes.
Okay.
And that's actually not the truck. It's an older photo, but that's generally the area where the truck was.
Okay. Because this is a Google image, is that right? Okay. So after the truck, can you explain why you have the other markings on the app?
The other markings are where Christopher Teeter was detained in the rear of the actual Petro main building behind the iron skillet.
You've documented that by way of the red circle?
Correct.
Okay.
And the actual argument that we learned occurred prior to our arrival, prior to the incident occurring, was in the iron skillet restaurant, which is located here.
Okay, and you've indicated that by a black circle, and that's at the bottom of the map, is that right?
Correct. And then this is the site that we determined in this general area where we believe the stabbing to have occurred.
Now, why do you have the red circle there? Why do you believe that the stabbing occurred there?
Based upon the blood trail leading from where the victim was located around the pumps, we believe that that was his area where he ran, but also where the victim's hat was located, we believe, may have been knocked off during the struggle.
Maybe I should ask this, but approximately how many feet in front of the truck was the hat located?
I believe it was approximately 30 feet.
Okay. I think that's all your markings on the map, is that correct?
Yes.
So it was based on the evidence and the crime scene in your investigation as to why you created this? Upon returning to the station with the knife, before turning over to the Burlington prosecutor's office, did you photograph it?
I did.
Okay. And I'm going to show you what's been marked as S15 for identification. Is that the photo that you took?
Correct.
And is that an accurate representation of the photo as you know it to be?
It is.
And at that time, had you secured the knife into that box that we see?
Yes.
All right, this time it's safe to move S15 in.
No objection.
No objection.
Okay. So this is the photograph that you took of the knife back at the station?
Correct.
And you say that you personally secured it into that box?
Yes.
And then turned it over to the Burlington County Prosecutor's Office?
Correct.
Now, after securing the knife, photographing it, what, if anything, did you do in this case?
I assisted with the preparation of complaints and the facts regarding the warrant for the vehicle.
Now, did you, at some point, was the defendant processed within the station?
He was.
Now, at any time, whether it be during the processing of the defendant or while you were interacting with him on the scene asking for his ID, did at any time you see any marks on the defendant of any type?
No.
Any bruises on the defendant?
Not that I noticed.
Did he ever complain of any marks, bruises, cuts, anything?
Not to my knowledge, no.
Did the defendant at any time, to your knowledge, call the police for help?
No.
State has no further questions, Your Honor.
Thank you. Mr. Masciocchi, your witness.
Thank you, Your Honor. Detective Pavlov, following up on counsel's last question, you processed the defendant at the station.
I assisted with the preparation of complaints, the processing, fingerprinting, so on and so forth, was done by patrol officers.
And you indicated that you didn't see any cuts or abrasions or any injuries on the defendant at that time.
I did not have much interaction with Mr. Teeter at the station at all. No.
So you didn't really examine him to see if he had any injuries or abrasions, cuts, or anything of that kind?
Personally, I did not.
Did you, in preparation for today's testimony, did you review the miscellaneous services report prepared by the Burlington County Prosecutor's Office and authored by Detective Warren?
No, I did not.
back, looking at the, Your Honor, may I approach?
You may. And give the court's continuing information.
Looking at this, this is a Google map photograph of the area, correct?
Yes.
This is not what the area looked like on the day of the incident.
Correct.
So this is your recollection of where the Covenant truck was. And this is where the defendant was detained. And this is where Mr. Stevens ends up, where he's ultimately rendered first aid.
Right.
So starting with Mr. Stevens, did you have any interaction with Mr. Stevens yourself?
No. Not on that date.
Now, your reactive information supplied to you, or that you may have gathered at the crime scene, you followed a blood trail from Mr. Stevens' first aid site, the blue circle on this picture, back to the red circle where you believe that the fight started.
In the direction of the red circle.
Right, okay. And between the red circle and the blue circle, you find a blood trail.
Yes.
Now, focusing on the red circle, where it's believed that the incident occurred, you, as you sit here today, have no idea knowing who started that incident.
Correct.
And you don't know who pulled out the knife first, for example.
Correct.
When you're going from the red circle to the blue circle, you're following a blood trail to try to piece together what happened, correct?
Correct.
Are you looking for any other kind of evidence, any other weapons, or any identification that may have fallen out of either of the parties' pockets or anything like that?
We canvassed the area. I didn't notice anything of note besides the blood.
Now, when you're canvassing the area, are you specifically looking just for blood or for any type of evidence that may have been located between the red circle and the blue circle?
We look for any type of evidence.
How about between this red circle up here and the site where Mr. T was ultimately detained?
No.
How about between the black circle where I believe this is the iron skillet, am I right?
Mm-hmm.
And between the iron skillet and going back to the Covenant truck, did you look for any evidence between that location and where you believe the Covenant truck was parked?
I personally did not.
Inside the truck, did you conduct a search inside the cab of the truck where the men drove and where they cohabitated?
I entered the truck and I secured the knife in the bag.
Okay, now, other than securing the knife in the bag, finding the bank statement that contained the ID, did you look for any other evidence inside?
I looked for Mr. Teeter's ID.
Okay, but nothing else?
No, not at that time.
I have no other questions of the detective. Thank you.
Thank you. State, any additional questions?
Yes, sir.
Detective, you had testified earlier that there were multiple officers on scene, is that fair to say?
Correct.
Were some of them, while you're at the truck and then looking for the blood trail, where are all the other officers at?
While I was at the truck and looking for the blood trail, I believe some of the officers had been told to go back and begin their reports. I believe they had left the scene. I'm not sure where everybody was at that point.
At some point, did officers respond to the iron skillet and look for evidence and speak for witnesses?
Yes.
At some point, did officers respond to the area where they detained the defendant and look for evidence and speak to witnesses?
Yes.
At some point, were there a bunch of medical personnel and officers where Mr. Stevens was located?
Yes.
And look for evidence and speak to witnesses?
Yes.
And why do you believe the blood trail goes this way? Why not cut through these gas pumps?
It's my belief that the fuel line was very busy throughout the day. Trucks coming in to fuel. It's very possible that there was a truck there. Again, I can't say for sure. I wasn't there at the time. But the fact that it isn't a direct line suggests that there was objects in the way preventing him from running a more direct route and just following the blood trail. We found a drop of blood very near the end, which would suggest very near the end of this fuel island, which would lead me to believe that had he run through the fuel island or through this bay, it would have been more on a more direct route instead of right on the corner. So I believe that he went around the fuel island.
Now, if there was one of those big tractor trailers in this area, could the victim even have fit through there?
It's possible that he could have fit through there, yes.
Okay. Now, you may not have personally searched the truck, but are you aware that the truck was ultimately thoroughly searched?
It was.
And who searched the truck?
Members of the Burlington County Prosecutor's Office.
Okay. And to your knowledge, was there any other weapons aside from this knife that was in the defendant's bag found on the truck or anywhere on this site?
Not to my knowledge, no.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Mr. Masciocchi?
Yes, Your Honor. Now, when officers are start with the man skillet down here, they're going into question witnesses. Do you understand they were looking for evidence as well there?
I believe they went in and spoke to witnesses and conducted some type of investigation.
And an investigation would then include searching for evidence in that area?
I cannot speak to that.
Going back to where the where Mr. Teeter was detained, were there officers in that area where he was assisting in detaining him?
Yes.
And do you know if they found any evidence in that particular area? Now, with regard to the blood trail from this red circle where the yellow square was indicating where the covenant truck was parked, and going back to Stephen's first aid site, you examined this area for any evidence, correct? Did anyone else besides yourself do the same?
I was there with, I believe, Troma Hess. Troma McGuire was walking in my direction. I'm the one charged with investigating, so they were assisting me walking that route. And we also walked it later with Detective Horn.
Did you instruct either McGuire, Hess, or Horn to look for, to keep an eye out for weapons in the air?
Did I personally instruct them?
Yeah, no. No other questions.